Okay, so my talk is, as already announced, it's about some mean field type limits. And in some sense, you can this is related to the talk of Enrique Zuazur from this morning, where he was speaking about many particle systems or interacting many particle systems. And this is actually what I would like to do now, but I'm more interested in the limiting behavior. That means I would like to derive limiting models from these particle systems. And this particle systems, which I will detail in a minute. Okay, so the motivation is that I would like to derive so-called cross-diffusion systems. So there are systems here written in blue, which are quasi-linear parabolic equations. So my main interest in some sense to analyze them from an analytical and numerical viewpoint. And they appear in many different applications from population dynamics over ion transport in cells. So can be some batteries or biological cells. You also may have them in multi-component fluids and in many other applications, since in fact nature is composed by multiple species. And what I would like to do is not only to analyze these cross-diffusion systems, but also to see from whether they can be derived from kind of first principles from physics. And well, this is the motivation. I would like to have a nice, good ground for these systems. And well, how can we derive them? So one possible way is to do it by kinetic equations, but it's not so easy. Therefore, I start with particle systems. And to motivation, how can expect, I will start with so-called single particle systems. That means more or less the system like what Enrique was presenting to us this morning. So you have a kind of your stochastic xk, a kind of random position. And this is a stochastic differential equation governed by an interaction potential here called B, depending on the difference of two kind of different deals, if you like, xk and xj. And you're adding some random factor here by the Brownian motion. So WK are independent Wiener processes. And the situation here is nice. So the B interaction potential is usually a Lipschitz continuous function. That means we do not have to deal with singularities. And here you're averaging all these differences. Okay, basic argument, what can you expect when you want to pass to the limit and going to infinity in a sense? I already said that this kind of average. So that means you expect that in the limit, this will be the expectation value rating of B. But the expectation value, every of density U can be written like this integral over RD. And this integral, you see immediately, it's a convolution. So you would expect limiting equation for the probability density U is given by this parabolic problem here, where you have the sigma, which here the diffusion coefficient and the Laplace, which just comes here from the averaging of the Wiener process, and then you have a kind of non-local term here. I'm also interested in a so-called localization limit. That means this B has interaction radius which becomes smaller and smaller, and finally convergence distribution, and see what you get quadratic type degeneration or kind of modification. Okay, the situation when species. And now I'm interested in multiple species. And let me first consider a simple particle system, that one here, where in addition to the situation we had before, we also have the sum over all species. So that means I have now a particle index, which goes from k to 1 to capital N, and have a species index, which goes for I from 1 to small n. Okay, so I just then have here the sum over all these other averages, if you like. I have an additional index, which is here the I already mentioned, and I have here some initial conditions. And the initial conditions, xi ik, they are independent and identically distributed with some common density ui0. And the wik are, again, independent Wiener processes. The interaction potential here, I assume some conditions. Okay, so I'm not at the first particle system when I sum over all species indices, and I'm going to explain to you the conditions on the interaction potential. And I already said that the interaction potential depends on an interaction radius, eta here, which just tells me that I have kind of approximation of the delta distribution. So I have some bijs, which are nice functions, C infinity functions with bounded support, if you like, written in this way. The integral here is given by some numbers, aij, which are positive or negative. And you see easily whether the L1 norm here is preserved. And if eta goes to zero, then converging to a delta distribution times this factor, ij. Okay? In the sense of distributions. Okay, so what is now, what do we expect when I pass to the limits in some sense? So if n goes to infinity, that means I'm increasing the number of individuals, then like in the single species, that we get a non-local stochastic equation. And when second step, I pass to the limit of vanishing interaction radius, either, then I get back a local stochastic differential equation. With a probability density, and that's the point which is important here, that satisfies our PDE, the cross diffusion system I would like to get. Okay, by Ito's lemma. Okay, that is somehow the strategy of the limit. And for that one, I need to introduce an intermediate particle system. And in fact, what we have done is just interpretation or extension of the method of Oehlschläger. And also what Angela Stephens was doing some decades ago. Okay, so let me repeat the kind of macroscopic particle system, which I've written on the previous slide already. When n now goes to infinity, in some sense, I need to make precise, then I expect to get intermediate particle system for some stochastic processes here with a bar, x bar, which already contains convolution of some function eta j, which solves non-local. Okay, and then eta goes to zero, then this convolution collapses to just the probability density, and because of in they get a gradient uj, and uj is then the probability density associated to the random to the stochastic process x hat. Okay. And ui then is expected to satisfy this cross diffusion system with the sigma I, which are here given the diffusion coefficients, and the aij, I recall you, these are just the numbers which appear when you pass to the limit eta going to zero, yeah, which are hidden here in the definition of the interaction radius. Okay, so in fact, this we can do it on a rigorous level, and this is joint work with Li Chen from Mannheim and Esther Daus from Vienna. And what we could prove is that whenever we have a certain relation between eta and eta in the action and of particles, delta here is the small constant, then we can prove that the difference between the solution of the original and the kind of macroscopic system and that is the macroscopic system is in some norm. That means I have the supreme norm with respect to Tim. And the expectation back to the stochastic level is given up to a constant times eta. Here, the capital T is just the frame. Okay. Proof is really difficult to exploit the discontinuity of the interaction potentials and estimate the difference of two or three systems. So the first, the second system, and then the second system. Then triangle inequality becomes line here. And then we just have to estimate the expectation. And what you expect is that estimate here the first two systems, well, that's some power of n of the particles, while the expectation here should be something depending on eta. In fact, the case is the result that expectation is given. This value here, and if delta needs to be small, this truly is decreased, and the second is C. And when we choose here this relation between our eta and n in the right way, then we get this error bound. Okay. Okay, let us consider the limiting sim in more detail. And some people of you know that I'm interested in the entropy, or what I call the entropy structure. And let us see what kind of structure do we have here for limiting system. And that's interesting. First of all, we have such a kinetic theory. We have a kind of Boltzmann or type entropy density. So then I define here U terms and sum of all of them. But I have some PIs. And the PIs, they are numbers assumed that exist, and they're given by this expression. That means they assume that the matrix PIAJ is symmetric. They assume that it's also positive definite. So this assumption I need to impose. Do that, then you can see that the time derivative is entropy density, or entropy belongs to the loop of this equation here given in blue, is given by this term here, the first part entropy production, standard information coming here from the diffusion operator, and the second part of the diffusion here given by this expression, the gradient, two norms of the entities. Factor which is the sign view of the matrix A. Surprising, well, let me say that this may be not too surprising something, since you would expect that the U log U would be X because of the stochastic origin. But what is somehow surprising is that there exists this entropy density, which is of present structure, but it's all the species. Indeed, when you differentiate the entropy, then you get some term which is associated here to the diffusion coefficients. So A sigma smallest eigenu or product of the mass A and sigma, which is positive. And you have an attribution, which is named, well, if you like, of kinetic energies. And when you interpret U as a density, the gradient Pi as a velocity, and the P as a T potential, then the net will respond to a kinetic G. So I call this tau-type entropy density. This comes from the fact that in biology, in population dynamics, this kind of entropy or Lyapunov is then and has been first found by how, but completely in context. We also mentioned with Zurich, he's now in Vienna, originally from France. We did some neural and mathematical analysis. Okay, so the first particle system, in fact, original motivation was to derive a model from quantum dynamics. And that model, what shown to you now, is not actually the model we had in mind. And then we modified the stochastic differential system by allowing for diffusions which are depend on interaction potentials given by this expression. So this is a bit different from the model. Here the statistic part just given by some given environment potentials, UI. It's important they could do if you like. And the main part here is given by this term here. Okay, here these FNs, this is given, started to explain to you the second particle system, the nonlinearity in the diffusion coefficient. And the rest is the same. So we have WIK, again, independent Wiener processes. We have some initial data, which is independent, identically distributed. I mentioned that the capital UI are some given environmental potentials. This project is exactly like in the before, but just that they don't have a gradient here. Now here I only have the potential, which makes sense. So compared to the system I've shown you, I have action in the diffusion coefficients. And that changes the system in the limit. We expect in the limit. So these five F and E, which is given here by this, it looks expected, or the sum of the expectation of J, which I've explained to you, is given by evolution. Here, the evolution limit goes should behave like this picture here. And course of the Wiener process should give a Laplace, a diffusion. The expect that in the limit, the diffusion operator is given by this term. So the U is coming from the fact that Ui is the density which you need to incorporate in the limit. Okay, let's see if this is really the system getting. And for that, I consider again three systems. So this microscopic system, the media system, n goes to unity in some sense, and the kind of microscopic system, the interaction radius goes to. Let me mention that see that if n goes to infinity, then maybe you would expect that this xk is disappearing since k comes for the number of particles, but I have the k here in the immediate system. Where is it from? Well, this is from the fact that the k here in the intermediate system only occurs the initial datum, yeah, and nothing else. So it's really a kind of infinitely many particle system. Okay, so expect that here is some here is the convolution, the probability density beta j satisfies a local PDE, and in the limit beta goes to zero, expect that this reduces to ui the factor aij. And uj or ui is just a probability density associated to the stochastic test x and solves PDE, which is given by this one. So I have here a drift term, takes on the interaction for the environmental potential capital I and Laplacian of ui times, well, what I get in this. Compared to what I think on the slide before, I also this I which I vectored before. This we can prove, and recently we did it. Also, Fleet Chen, Esaus, and Daus, and PhD student of mine, Alexander Singer. And I explain this theorem just in case that we have a non-confinement potential, a quadratic one, which is given by this one. I will comment in these settings why we did it. And then when we have a relation between beta and n, in this way, it's very like in the first theorem, then we can bound the error between the system, the microscopic one and the macroscopic one, in term eta, in terms of action radius. Okay. And the proof is similar to the first system. There's some technical difficulties which come from the fact we have a nonlinear diffusion coefficient. And the second difficulty is from the fact that the interaction is not an L2 function space. Yeah. So we do need here this quad potential. You can generalize this, but then you need quite a number of contours. There's an generation which is more interesting, and that is the case when I have a linearity or another nonlinearity in the diffusion coefficient. We have here this edge, which you have seen now many times on my slides. And in front, I put in a nonlinearity. You will see, I'll explain to you in a minute we are doing this. And in fact, what I need here is nonlinearity just Lipschitz continuous. Since I said I'm only in the Lipschitz continuous work, this is a theory for the ease is simpler. But I have in mind nonlinearities, maybe are not Lipschitz, only Lipschitz. Therefore, I introduce here the parameter eta is a parameter like here for the radius, just for convenience. I assume that this family of Lipschitz functions is changing the only Lipschitz. And then in the mean field limit, we get then this nonlinearity here in the coefficient. And therefore, for this is in the French rule, especially by Le Poulet, Divillette, Moussa, Trescas, they have considered these kind of problems here arising from population dynamics with an which is a power function. And the power function locally Lipschitz. And we won't have this case. By property, we are seeing the derivation of this medium equation. And that's quite interesting for the single species case. We have here this equation, which is the starting point. We do this kind of limit. and getting this equation here with u times f of u. I've explained to you before that we get a quadratic square. Here we overcast quadratic of any structure. And that's interesting since Sigali or Filippovi already derived the transmediation from particle systems years ago, 2008. But they needed a double constructor here in this drift coefficient to get this post-median type equation. And our derivation is another, another possibility to derive. Okay. And I found it interesting. Okay. Let us consider this limit system here written with the supply. And I said that this appears in problem dynamics, has been suggested already in the 70s by Shige, Sawazaki, and Teramoto. And there's a lot of literature on the mathematical analysis. I only meant work paper, more or less papers for the two-species system. And then you see quite some years are in bid to cover the multi-species system, and Michael Dreher, he could do it in space, so did in bound planes. And it has an entropy term of a Boltzmann. So again, we need an assumption on the coefficient AI here, and we need to assume you have ice such that this holds. When you are familiar with probability theory, then you see that the P is interpreted as the measure of the Markov chain associated to numbers AIJ. Okay. And get is this P structure. So the H1 given by this U term is monofunctional entropy production of these two yards, one coming from the standard formation structure, the second year coming from this expression, which is given here. And for this, to say, compared to the mean field system, see that we have an additional division, not only the sigma is, but this term here. And I aim, and I will explain to you this on the next slide, that an effect which is important in patient dynamics, since these three Jack authors, they have this order to segregation, means the relation is they don't like each other and they are too separate. So this segregation is in fact weaker than the first model. I come to this point later. Another difference, the first model has two double entropy structure, which is quite interesting. To make clear what I mean by the negation effect, here now in a numerical example, and for them I consider the microscopic system, the first model, the second system here in the Y variable, this is down here, and we have discretized this by a very simple Euler-Maruyama discretization. We took Gaussian initial data, and to accelerate a little bit the process, we have parallelized this. As the interaction potential, using here this stated exponential function, we do not have any environmental potential, just to simply heat. We took 5,000 particles. Each of the pictures, we have five simulations, and then we reached everything. As parameters, choose coefficients, and these AIJs are given here in this way. And here you see that we really very just cross diffusion. What's shown here in the pictures on the x-axis is the still variable, and the y-axis are what are histograms. So we are showing the probability. We have two species in blue and in red. And you see on the first, so this the first system, very strong segregation. So this means here that this blue particle really doesn't have a red particle, and they to avoid each other. This segregation effect is so strong in the second particle system, which has been derived by these three Japanese authors to model segregation. since the blue, because there are some blue parts zone where the radicals dominate. So that means this particle system has longer cyclic gain. And if you have two moles input in body, then maybe the fill is better. Let me summarize. In this talk, what I did is, well, just to give you two simple derivations of confusion systems for particle systems, where you get action in the drift term, the diffusion part. And this modified where the limiting system, where you either hear this kind of order operator or just the plot outside. Okay, it's for beginning to understand more, what we can do with these kind of systems. And what we do now is based the techniques of Xijin is to implement a random batch method to accelerate the numerical simulations. So this has been also mentioned in Enrique's talk, together with Esther Daus and Markus Fellner, another PhD student. And what I'm also interested in are PDEs, means I would understand here in these PDEs, I can add a kind of stochastic term. And up to now, we did it in a specific way. But maybe we can derive them, and one way to do it in some sense is to study the fluctuation. That means to include order corrections, or more precisely not to follow the large numbers what I have today, but to look central limit theorem. And this is also work with the people I've already mentioned. In some sense, what I'd like to answer is the question. Or can we justify an equation which is given here in B, where we have the right hand side, well, they're not written very precisely, the dt should be a dui over that, and I should put a dt here on this side, where I have, well, where I have a stochastic part. I would like to do it in a rigorous way. I would drive, yeah, if we just add heuristically, that the equation is, can be better. Okay, that's all what I wanted to say, and sorry for this technical problems that you could nevertheless enjoy the talk. Thank you very much.